Hello friends, welcome to Science for Common Man. Let's go to a magic room. It's dark here, and let me switch on a white light. That's nice. We have three balls here, red, white, and blue. Now, let's switch off white light and switch on a red light. That's interesting. Now we have two red balls and a black ball. Let's switch off red light and switch on a blue light. That's more interesting. Now we have two blue balls and one black ball. This is not magic. It's science of colors. Let's dive into it. Let's first understand how we see an object. We all have seen this beautiful moon. Let's understand how we see it. Moon is certainly not producing its own light, but it receives light from sun. When sunlight falls on its surface, it scatters or reflects light in all directions, and that reflected light travels from moon and reaches our eyes and we see it. That means this ball is white because white light is reflected by the surface of the ball and it is reaching our eyes. And this is red because red light is reflected by it, and this is blue because blue light is reflected by it. But our light source is white. Then from where is this blue and red coming out? Let's solve this first. I have a blue light projected onto the screen here. Let's project another green light and a red light here. Now see the color where three intersect. It's white. That is, this white is created by adding these three color lights. And if we change the intensity of any of these colors, or if I remove some specific color in specific proportion from white light, we get different colors. That means white light is a mixture of these colors, and in white light exists all colors. So when I say that our light source here is white, it means that I am sending all these colors to the object. And when I say that white light is reflected from this ball, it means that this ball is reflecting all the colors falling on its surface. But the source was white for red ball and blue ball also, and they also received all the colors, but red ball reflected only red color and blue ball reflected only blue color. What happened to other colors that fell on these balls? They absorbed it and did not come out. Red ball absorbed everything except red light, and blue ball absorbed everything except blue light. Why? To crack it, let's know first what is this red light, blue light, etc. They are nothing else but just traveling packets of energy called photons. Red light has the lowest energy and blue light has the highest. Where do they come from? Believe me, all the light that we see in this world starts from and end in something called atoms. Yes, the same atoms with which everything in this world is made up of. Inside atoms, in the center, there is a massive object called nucleus, and there are electrons which move around the nucleus in specified slots. The actual movement is much complicated than this, but what we know for sure is that there is a specified amount of energy associated with each slot. And we can think of these electrons as living in steps of increasing energies like this. The electron with the lowest energy in the lowest step, and so on. The height between the steps represents the difference in energy levels between the slots. In any atom or in interconnected atoms called molecule which make up a material, there is a unique step and electron configuration which is default, and we can call it as most preferred or stable configuration. Now, what happens when a red photon enters into this? Red photon carries an energy of 1.6 electron volts. If this energy corresponds to that of this step, the electron here will swallow this photon and jump to next step, and the photon vanishes. The head of the atom, nucleus, doesn't like this, and at this new place, the electron is not stable, and it soon jumps back to its stable state, and in this process, it expels the photon of same energy. So, a red photon swallowed and red photon emitted. This is how light is reflected. Now, if a material has steps of all levels that correspond to energies of all colors, all photons will be swallowed and re-emitted. Since all photons are coming out, the material becomes white in color. Now, how can we make this material colored, say red? For that, first we need it to swallow all colors, and then it should expel or emit only red. Or we need to provide enough steps for upward jumping of electrons, but we should limit downward jumping just to one energy level of that of red. To limit downward jumping, we can provide small steps between the higher steps like this wherever required, so that we can make electrons walk down through these smaller steps and prevent jumping down. And during this walk down, they make more contacts with other particles or induce vibrations in the atoms, which heats the material, and thus energy is expelled as heat in this process. So, designing a color is all about mixing of atoms, making a molecule, and thus providing different steps for transitions of electrons and arriving at desired electronic configurations. What about black material? It swallows all colors and emits nothing, or converts all energy to heat. That is why wearing a black dress makes you hot. And what if the energy levels in the materials are too high compared to the light energy? Photons are not absorbed, light pass through, and the material becomes transparent like glass. Now, let's go to magic room again. Under white light, all balls receive all photons. White ball reflects everything. Red is tuned to reflect only red, and blue is tuned to reflect only blue. And in red light, we have only red photons. White ball will reflect everything that comes in. So, it would reflect this red also and appear red. Red ball is designed to absorb everything and reflect only red. So, when red photons come, it can absorb it and reflect red and would appear red. But blue ball is tuned to absorb everything and reflect only blue. So, when it receives red photons, it absorbs it. Since blue photons are not received, it cannot reflect anything and appears black. Similarly, in blue color, white and blue appear blue and red appears black. So next time, before you decide the color of the costume for your stage performance, think about the color of the light in stage also, because your red color may appear black to the audience. Thank you for watching. Subscribe and support us. Signing off, Science for Common Man.